हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मोस्ट वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मैथ्स बाय समित देशमुख। सो टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल, मींस एग्जांपल नंबर 10th फ्रॉम मिसलिनियस एक्सरसाइज 6B क्वेश्चन नंबर 2। इन दिस एग्जांपल वी आर फाइंडिंग वेक्टर इक्वेशन ऑफ प्लेन पासिंग थ्रू दिस पॉइंट, मींस वन पॉइंट ऑन द प्लेन इज गिवन टू अस एंड पैरेलल टू दिस टू वेक्टर्स, मींस अ प्लेन पासेस थ्रू द पॉइंट and parallel to two vector. In such case, we will have one formula to find out vector equation of plane. What is that formula? Vector equation of plane in this case can be find out as r bar dot b bar cross c bar is equals to a bar dot b bar cross c bar. So when this formula is applicable, if a bar is given to us, what is a bar? A bar is the position vector of given point on the plane. So one point on the plane is given to us, so we are denoting its position vector by a bar. A bar be the position vector of this given point on this plane. From the coordinate of this point, we will get the value of position vector, means a bar. What will be its value? 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap. So first value is known to us. Now we will require the value of what? B bar cross c bar. And here b bar and c bar are what? Two vector parallel to the plane. Here also two vector parallel to the plane are given to us. Let us denote first vector by b bar and second vector by what? C bar. So let or already we have written here let, and here just simply write down and b bar is equals to what is the value of b bar? 4i cap plus 3j cap, and c bar is equals to I cap plus j cap are vectors parallel to the plane. So to apply our formula, we have to find out cross product of these two vector. So therefore b bar cross c bar, and we know that cross product can be find out using determinant. Now already in many example we have seen how to find out cross product. In the second row, write down the coefficients from b bar. What are the coefficient? 4 3, so here k cap is there, sorry, 3k cap, so 4 0 3, and coefficient from c bar are what? 1 1 0. Let us simplify this determinant. First we are writing I cap, so to find out its coefficient, delete this column, find out determinant of these four elements. 0 minus 3 means here we will get minus 3. Plus j cap is there, so write down here minus j cap, delete this column, find out determinant of these four elements. So this product is 0, 0 minus 3 will be minus 3, minus and this minus will become plus 3. Lastly, let us try to find out coefficient of k cap, delete this column, find out determinant of these four elements. 4 minus 0 will be equal to what? Plus 4. Once this value is known to us, substitute all these values in this formula. So therefore r bar dot, what is the value of b bar cross c bar? That is minus 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. And on the right hand side, first substitute the value of a bar, otherwise here write down a bar. What is value of a bar here? Minus 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap. Keep this dot as it is, then substitute the value of this cross product, that is minus 3i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. So which is equals to, now find out the value of this dot product. So minus 2 into minus 3 is plus 6, 3 3s are what? 9, and 5 4s are what? 20. So what we are getting on this side? So which is equals to, on this side we will get 15 plus 25 means 35. So that is r bar dot, what is left hand side? Minus 3 I cap plus 3 j cap plus 4 k cap. And on right hand side, what we are getting? 35. And this is nothing but our required vector equation of plane. See, in this example number 11th, question is to find out Cartesian equation of plane. So if you will observe the given equation of plane, it is in parametric form. When we can say that equation is in parametric form, if it is in the form of r bar is equal to a bar plus lambda b bar plus mu c bar. Such type of representation is called as what? Equation of plane in parametric form. Here a bar is the position vector of one point on the plane. B bar and c bar are vector parallel to the plane. Here term of a bar is absent. Its meaning is that a bar is expressed as what? 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap. Means it is a zero vector. That's why here a bar does not appear. Means in short we can say that this plane passes through the origin, isn't it? So here we can say that this plane passes through origin. You are getting it? Why we are saying that it passes through the origin? Because a bar does not appear here. A bar does not appear means it is zero vector. And since it is a zero vector, so not necessary to write down zero vector in this equation. So this plane passes through the origin having position vector a bar is equal to 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap and parallel to which two vector? These two vector. Denote this vector by b bar. B bar is equal to I cap plus j cap minus k cap, and c bar is equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. Now here two vector parallel to the plane are known to us from this equation, and from this equation here we can say that plane passes through the origin whose position vector we have denoted by what? A bar. What's the value of a bar, b bar and c bar is known to us. Equation of plane can be find out applying which formula? Which we have applied in the last example. What is that formula? So therefore vector equation of plane is r bar dot b bar cross c bar is equals to a bar dot b bar cross c bar. But to apply this formula we will require cross product of these two vector. So find out the cross product. This implies that b bar cross c bar is equal to, cross product can be find out using determinant. So in the second row what are the coefficient? 1 1 minus 1. Elements of third row are 1 2 3. Now simplify this determinant. First we are finding coefficient of I cap, delete this column. This product is 3 minus minus 2 means plus 2. 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. So here we will get 5 I cap. Now find out coefficient of j cap, delete this column. This product is 3. 3 minus minus means plus 1. 3 plus 1 is equal to what? 4. As you stand here plus j is there, so we are taking here minus j. Lastly find out coefficient of what? K cap. So for that purpose delete this column. This product is 2. 2 minus 1 will be equals to 1. So here nothing is there means 1 is there. In this way we have got the value of cross product. Now remaining part is just to substitute this value in this formula. So what we'll get here? R bar dot B bar cross C bar. What is its value? 5 I cap minus 4 J cap plus K cap. And on this side replace a bar by its value. What is the value of a bar? Its value is equal to 0 I cap plus 0 j cap plus 0 k cap dot value of b bar cross c bar is equals to 5 I cap minus 4 j cap plus k cap. Now find out the dot product of these two vector. We know that zero dot product of zero vector with any vector is what? 0. And on the left hand side keep r bar dot 5 I cap minus 4 j cap plus k cap as it is. So this is what? Vector equation of plane. But question is to find out what? Cartesian equation. To find out Cartesian equation we are substituting r bar is equals to, let r bar is equal to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. What is r bar? Any point on the plane. Position vector of any point. And coordinate of any point we are denoting by what? X y z. That's why value of r bar will be equals to x I cap plus y j cap plus z k cap. If we are substituting this value here, what we will get? Therefore एक्स आई कैप प्लस वाई जे कैप प्लस जेड के कैप, कीप दिस डॉट एज इट इज, फाइव आई कैप माइनस फोर जे कैप प्लस के कैप, कीप इट एज इट इज, ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड जीरो कीप इट एज इट इज. नाउ वी आर टेकिंग डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दिस टू वेक्टर, फाइव इंटू एक्स विल बी इक्वल्स टू फाइव एक्स, देन माइनस फोर इंटू वाई विल बी माइनस फोर वाई, एंड वन इंटू जेड विल बी इक्वल्स टू जेड. ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड कीप जीरो एज इट इज, एंड दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड कार्टेशियन इक्वेशन ऑफ प्लेन. दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड कार्टेशियन इक्वेशन ऑफ प्लेन. इन दिस वे वी हैव गॉट अवर रिक्वायर्ड कार्टेशियन इक्वेशन ऑफ प्लेन हियर. So now observe the example number 12. In this example, question is to find out Cartesian equation of plane passing through these two points and makes equal intercept on the coordinate axis. Means we have to find out, remember the question, find the Cartesian equations of the plane. Means here more than one equation exists. That's why they are saying that find the Cartesian equations of the planes. Means more, you're getting it, more than one planes are there. And this plane passes through these two points and make equal intercept on the coordinate axis. So in this case, we are considering two different cases. Since we have to find out equations of the plane here. Okay, if this question is find a equation, so at that time not necessary to consider both cases. In the first cases, we are supposing that the plane makes intercept zero on each coordinate axis. Already it is given to us that plane makes what? Equal intercept. Means if the intercept made on x-axis is zero, means intercept on y-axis and z-axis is also what? Zero. Just try to understand. Now here, if x-intercept means what? X-coordinate of a point where the plane intersect x-axis. Agar plane x-axis ko intersect karta hai, to y-coordinate or z-coordinate, wo point ke y-coordinate or z-coordinate kya honge? Zero. And x-intercept is zero means x-coordinate is also zero. That's why we can say that plane passes through what? Origin. So therefore, we can say that plane passes through origin. And if plane passes through origin, so we can say that Cartesian equation of plane is, we know that equation of plane in general form can be written as what? Ax plus by plus cz plus d is equals to 0. But here d is absent. We are not written d here because plane passes through what? Origin. And we know that whenever the plane passes through origin, at that time constant term in that plane is what? Absent. Its value is 0. Why its value is 0? Because if it passes through origin, means its coordinate satisfies this equation. So let us check whether this coordinate satisfies this equation or not. Replace x by 0, y by 0, z by 0. All the three terms will become 0. So 0 plus 0 plus 0 is 0. Means left hand side is 0 and it is equal to what? Right hand side also. Means the equation will be satisfied by the coordinate of origin only if constant term is also what? Zero here. Okay, so we have got the equation of plane here. Now, if it is the equation of plane, then our aim is to find out unknown value A, B, C. So to find out this unknown value, we will use the condition that plane passes through these two points. So this plane passes through the point. Passes through points, which points having coordinate 1, 2, 3 and coordinate 3, 2, 1. Since this is the point on this plane, means coordinate of this point satisfies this equation. So replace x by x coordinate, so replace x by 1, 1 into a is a, replace y by y coordinate means by 2, 2 into b is 2b, and lastly 3 into c will be equals to what? 3c is equals to 0, keep it as it is, And second equation, this is also the point on this plane. So coordinate of this point also satisfies this equation. So replace x by 3. So here we'll get 3a. Replace y by 2. So here we will get 2b. And lastly, replace z by what? 1. So 1 into c will be equals to c is equal to 0. So in this way, we have got two equations in terms of what? A, b and c. Let us solve these equations to find out a, b, c using determinant. So therefore, a upon determinant, here in this determinant, in the first column, write down coefficient of b, what are the coefficient? 2, 2, 2, 2. In the next column, write down coefficient of c, that is 3, 1, is equal to, instead of plus b, here we are writing minus b. This is the method to simplify or to find out the value of a, b, c using what? Determinant. In the denominator, write down determinant. Here in the first row, write down coefficient of A, that is 1, 3. And in the second row, write down coefficient of C, that is 3, 1. Then lastly, C upon determinant. Ab yahan pe kya nahi aane chahiye? C ke coefficient nahi aane chahiye. Yani first column mein A ke coefficient, 1, 3. And in the next column, write down coefficient of what? B, that is 2, 2. So 2, 2. Let us simplify. Simplify it. So what we will get here, therefore a upon, see here what we will get, 2 minus 6 will be minus 4 is equals to minus b, keep it as it is, and see what we will get here, 1 minus 9 will be equals to minus 8. And lastly, c upon, here 2 minus 6 will be what? Minus 4. So that's why we can say that therefore a upon minus 4 is equal to minus minus will get cancel, b upon 8 is equal to c upon minus 4. Therefore direction ratios of normal two plane are, what are the direction ratios? Minus 4, 8, minus 4. That is, these are direction ratios. We are able to write down it in the simplest form. And if you observe, all the terms are divisible by 4. Even two terms are negative. That's why I give the priority to divide all these terms by minus 4. If I'm dividing by minus 4, here we will get 1. Here we will get minus 2. Here we will get 1. Once these values are known to us, we can say that therefore, equation of required plane is it the equation of required plane? So replace a by what? 1, because these are direction ratios, means are the values of what? A, B, C. Here you, if you want, write down 1 minus 2, 1 denoted by what? A, B, C. Let us denote it, say, by A, B, C. So replace a by its value 1, 1 into x is x. Replace b by its value minus 2, minus 2y. And c also by what? 1. And 1 into z will be equals to z, is equal to 0. This will be our required equation of plane in case first. Now consider case second. In the case second, we will suppose that let the plane makes non-zero intercept. Let us denote that intercept by what? A. On each coordinate axis. On each coordinate axis. Therefore, equation of plane is, already in one example, we have proved equation of plane in what? Intercept form. What is that equation? X upon A plus Y upon B plus Z upon C is equal to 1. But here B is also what? A, means intercept on Y axis is also A, and intercept on Z axis is also what? A, because plane makes equal intercept, and that intercept I have denoted by what? A. If I am multiplying both sides by A, so what we'll get here? X plus Y plus Z is equal to A. Simply I am multiplying both sides by what? A. So this is required equation of plane, but to find out required equation, we will require the value of A. To find out the value of A, we are using the condition that plane passes through this point. So either use the coordinate of first point or use the coordinate of second point. That is our choice. So here we can say that this plane passes through point. Passes through true point, which point having coordinate 1, 2, 3. So since the plane passes through this point, means coordinate of this point satisfies this equation, means what we will get here, replace x by what, x coordinate means by 1, plus replace this y by y coordinate means by 2, plus replace z coordinate by what, z by z coordinate means 3, and on this side a keep it as it is equal to a. Okay, try to understand it. This implies that a is equal to how much? 6. So therefore, therefore equation of plane is, what result we are getting here, x plus y plus z is equal to a, but what is the value of a? 6. So x plus y plus z is equal to 6. In this way we have got our required Cartesian equation of plane. In the first case, what we have got, x minus 2y plus z is equal to 0. And in the second case, what we have got, x plus y plus z is equal to 6. If the question is simply to find out a Cartesian equation of plane, a Cartesian equation, yani ek koi to bhi plane find karo, jo ye sab condition kya karta hai, satisfy. In this case, we are giving priority to what? Case second. But question is to find out what? Equation of planes satisfying all these conditions. That's why we have solved this example in two cases. See, in the example number 13, question is to find out vector equation of plane which makes what, non-zero intercept. In the last example, what plane makes, it is not given to us that the plane make not non-zero intercept. It is given to us that find the equation of planes. That's why we have considered two cases. Is it clear? So here it is already given to us that the plane makes what, non-zero intercept on the coordinate axis and passes through this point. So first let us denote the intercept made by the plane on coordinate axis by what, a. Generally we are denoting it by what, a, b, c, but adjacent intercepts are equal. If we are denoting intercept on x-axis by a, then intercept on y-axis is also a, and on z-axis is also what, a, because plane makes equal intercept on coordinate axis. So here we are supposing that let the plane makes non-zero intercept, non-zero intercept. Non-zero intercept, I am denoting by what, a, sorry, non-zero intercept a on each coordinate axis. Okay, so now let us again revise what is the meaning of intercept made by the plane on coordinate axis. So let this will be say x-axis, y-axis, and what, z-axis. The plane where intersect x-axis, let us denote that point by a. Since it is a point on x-axis, means y-coordinate and z-coordinate are what, 0. And x-intercept is what, a. So b is a point on y-axis. Since it is a point on y-axis, means we can say that x-coordinate and z-coordinate are 0. And what is a y-intercept? Y-intercept is also a. And here z-intercept is also a. That's why here coordinate of this point are 0, 0, a. Getting it? Generally we are denoting z-intercept by what, c. But here plane makes what, equal intercept on coordinate axis, and that intercept we have denoted by a. So here in this way we have got coordinate of 3 point on the plane. So that's why we can say that therefore plane passes through the point, passes through the points, points which point, a having coordinate a 0 0, second point is what, b having coordinate 0 a 0, third point is what, c whose coordinates are 0 0 a. So now to find out vector equation, what is the formula if coordinate of 3 points are known to us? So therefore vector equation of plane is r bar dot ab bar cross ac bar is equals to a bar dot AB bar cross AC bar. This formula is applicable to find out vector equation of plane passing through 3 points. Here 3 points are known to us. So first we have to find out this cross product. To find out this cross product, find out AB bar and what? AC bar. And to find out AB bar and AC bar, we have to define its position vector. So from this coordinate, we are able to find out their position vector. Let A bar is equal to what? From this coordinate of A, we will get its position vector, it's AI cap. Then B bar is equals to its position vector is A J cap, because here 0 I cap is there, not necessary to write down 0 I cap plus A J cap plus 0 K cap. Don't write down the term of what? 0, having coefficient 0. And C bar is equal to what we will get here from this coordinate, we will get A K cap. Be the position vectors, be the position vectors of points A, B and C respectively. Once these values are known to us, so therefore AB bar can be find out as what? B bar minus A bar. What is the value of B bar? AJ cap minus A bar is equal to AI cap. First write down the term of I cap, means minus AI cap, then write down the term of J cap, AJ cap. In the same way, find out the value of AC bar, that is C bar minus A bar. What is the value of C bar here? AK cap. A K cap minus A bar is equal to A I cap. So first write down the term of I cap and then write down the term of what? K cap. A K cap. Once these values are known to us, we will require cross product of these two vectors. So let us try to find out cross product. So therefore A B bar cross A C bar is equals to I J K. So what are the coefficients in A B bar? That is minus A, A 0, and in the next vector minus A 0 A. So let us simplify it. So first we are trying to find out coefficient of what? I cap. So delete this column. So here A square minus 0 will be equals to what? A square. So plus J cap is there. So here write down minus J cap. So delete this column. This product is minus A minus 0 will be minus A square minus 0 is minus A square. Minus and this minus will become plus A square. Lastly, let us try to find out coefficient of K cap. Delete this column. This product is 0 minus minus means plus A square. In this way, we have got the value of this cross product. Lastly, let us substitute all these values in this formula. So R bar dot, what is the value of cross product? A square I cap plus A square J cap plus A square K cap. And on this side, replace A bar by its value. What is the value of A bar? A I cap dot, then write down the value of this cross product, that is A square I cap plus A square J cap plus A square K cap. Okay, so which is equals to, on this side, let us try to find out dot product of these two vectors, which are represented in Cartesian form. First take the product of coefficient of I cap, that is A into A square, it's A cube. Can I say that remaining term is 0? Because here term of J cap is missing and K cap is also missing. Means dot product will be equals to here A cube. So therefore A bar dot A square, okay, parallelly, okay, keep this side as it is, I cap plus A square J cap plus A square K cap. Now we can observe that all the terms in this equation are divisible by what? A square. If I'm dividing both sides by A square, here we will get R bar dot I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and on this side if I'm dividing by A square, we will get A. Here if I'm dividing by A square, A square, A square, A square will get cancelled, and on this side A cube upon A square is A. So in this way we have got equation of plane, but one unknown value is there. Which unknown value? A. That value of A we are trying to find out from the coordinate of given point on the plane. So we can say that this plane passes through point, passes through point having coordinate what? 1, 1, 1. Now what is R bar? R bar is any point on the plane. So that's why we are consider that R bar will be equals to what we'll get from this coordinate? I cap plus J cap plus K cap, because this is the point on the plane and R bar is what? Any point. So any point, R bar is any point, means this is also the point on the plane. So we are able to consider this as also the value of what? R bar. So if we are substituting this value of R bar, this implies that what we'll get? Replace R bar by
I cap plus J cap plus K cap. And here dot I cap plus J cap plus K cap, keep it as it is, on this side A also as it is, which implies that A is equal to, first take the product of coefficient of I cap, that is 1, then J cap, that is 1, and lastly product of coefficient of K cap is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. So hence we can say that, hence required vector equation of plane is this is the equation of plane, and here after substituting the value of coordinate of this point in this equation, we have got the value of A is equal to what, 3. Just we are replacing A by 3 here. So what we'll get, R bar dot I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and on this side replace A by its value 3. So in this way we have got our required vector equation of plane. So friends, if you like this video, please share with your friends, write down your comments in the comment box, and please subscribe the channel.